Hi, Mick and Jackie and Andy. Oh, and your kids. I'm just up. It's 6:42 a.m. It's dark. And doing my work. This is my office. That's the first office. That's the fridge there. All the goodies in it. And kitchen. And the other office. Computer there. That one's all set up. And the heater to keep me warm. And the other heater over there. Keeps the coffee going. Coffee pot. Hot water. That's my shower there. Over there. All good. Turn light out. And then that's what it looks like. And then we come into the other office, the printer there. And the hard disk. Bit of mess. Best mess in here. This bed, I don't see one. And this the other computer here. The sun's not up yet. It comes streaming through this window. There's my backyard out there. You can see it. Yeah. And then that's the look from here. And there's my paperwork there, lying all over the place. I can spread them out and see where I'm going. That's where I sleep, on this big long couch. I jump in the sleeping bag and chuck those on because it gets cold. generally I've got a lot of space now. And here's the other mess, the flag, the hat, the seal, star, 8-point star. We've got plenty of ample room to have another office in here. And I get going. That's all the books here, all the documents in the bag, and documents in the bag there and that one there. All the history. I burnt a lot. I only kept what I want. So that's it. And the supermarket down there, that's the. Oh, still dark. That's the accountant's office just here, and the supermarket over there. Not everybody's going to work. These ones here have just come to work and they'll be in here a minute. Rebel Sports over there. And my car is sitting over there. Put the light on so you can see. Over there. Yeah, that's my lawns. Right along here and at the back. And my shop is just there. I have hot meals all the time there. Police over there, just there. And my policeman, and the hardware stores at the back. What's it called? Oh, forgot now. Anyway, that's in the lawyers and everybody over there. The place is called Kirikiri. So that's it, really. And I'm comfortable in this little place. I cook my meals, but really I just get something from the supermarket. I'm chewing through this cake there, a big cake. A big cake there. And I've just had some. Oh, I love these. This only $2 for this. Yeah, I'm just demolishing them. Oh, I've demolished them before, and those ones there. Then the hangi over here, the hangi. That's the food cooked under the ground. And a printer put my feet on. That's it, really. That's me. The latest is this. Tell you guys. I'll put this over here. It's cold, that's why I've got a lot of clothes on. It's not too bad. It's starting to get a bit warmer. I'll just tell you what's going on here. Okay, greetings to you in Britain, UK. Matt Taylor and Jackie Little Gordon and Andy and Karina and Lizzie and Lewis, the little kids. And to my wife, Rosemary, Torres and the kids, Kazaya.
Jim and I, two girls, and Kieran, young kids, my family. The latest success, we have an investor, Harold Lee, in Thailand, and he's put together a contract for me. I'm pleased with it, but I have to be vigilant, to be very careful of the words. It's only one page of words, and I want to take them seriously, because he's offering the finance for the Moai Tidal Turbine project at Ranfurly Bank, which he chose. I wanted to go to Thailand, but he chose to have that site in Ranfurly Bank, off the east coast, 60 miles out of the East Cape Lighthouse, North Island, New Zealand, on my landmarks, Mora Ngairoa Chitwaba. So, he has drafted up the first part of the contract. This is for my staff, and Cecile Hood's here, in Papua, or rather Karaka, not Papua, Karaka, south of Auckland City, about an hour out. And so, Harold has carefully drafted a plan to invest $10 million, because he said, how much am I going to put in equity? That's his equity, $10 million, $1 million to start with. So I said, my equity is myself and the idea of a tidal turbine. I've given him a sketch picture of it, or an artist view of it, how it works. And I'm following up with a bit more information to disclose to him, because the project is already disclosed of its features and its looks on YouTube. There's 1585 YouTube videos, and any amount of them have that turbine displayed in it and how it works. So far, no one has been serious enough to put money in except angel investors. I've turned them all down. But I've taken Harold on board because he's generous enough to wait a long time since October last year till now to hang in there with me. Even though I've been to Philippines and back twice, he's still there. No doubt, I give him that much credit. So his equity is $10 million in the project. That's to finance 40 shares, 40% shares in the business. That's the turbine business. The distinction between the turbine, which is here in New Zealand, under New Zealand jurisdiction of the government and their rules of the sea and what not, of putting something that's never been done before at the seabed bottom and not floating on the top or on land. It's at the bottom of the ocean where only Scotland, Canada and Ireland have mastered that so far since 2008. Atlantis, that company that has the constitution and plans of following, and I'm taking a leaf out of their book. I've followed Scotland all along, and I'm meant to be in Scotland to do that turbine. But money is the driving factor that's missing. So I just parked it up and improved the idea until now. And then we come to an arrangement that he would give me a contract to sign under his terms with my views. My views are extensive on the tidal turbine because I'm the one that's got the idea in my head, putting on paper, but it needs to be finished in real. In order to get that, I needed funding. I've already got a share company in Britain or England with a 1 million shares. Registered now to a, sorry, my powerhouse group, limited company. And the parent company of that with 1 trillion shares, Ngā Atua Ewa Aotea Limited, registered here in New Zealand, the parent company or holding company. Harold has picked out Moai Powerhouse Group Limited, without identifying which country, and called it the principal. In legal terms, the principal is the one that's got the value in it. That's what he wrote. In saying that, he's accepted that as my equity value and putting forward 1 million. To start with, if I signed it, then would he sign mine? So I drafted my own document. Hang on a second. Over his document with my seal, a king seal, and a Moai crown seal. I say Moai crown because it's a memorial, both are memorial seals on the Grimm's group's document contract. So this is how I counter offer, like that. It's not finished yet. Okay? And there's another whole 8 pages after that. See, lawyers like less words, so I'll put my contract reply of offer on one page, just like his, with a mirror image of his words on my counter offer of the turbine and who owns it and what's the go. So, in his words, he has my powerhouse group. I looked up the word group, and it means all of that, which has the names of likeness in its corporate structure and corporate governance, meaning any company with a certain amount of shares, over 2,000 employees, and over $100 million or pounds in its account, and its revenue as being a percentage of shares. And so I opened up this new company, Moai Powerhouse Group, NZ1, out of 250 countries. Moai Powerhouse Group, East Island, 250. There. At 1 billion shares each. According to Harold Bing, he has 40% of all the revenue of all the companies that are using those words, Moai Powerhouse Group. Not the limited, the group, because the PLC, private limited company, can go and turn it around in Singapore and use their laws to override the corporate laws of Britain and New Zealand. So that my 60% shares can slip onto the other side of the 40% shareholding ownership if I don't perform. If I don't perform, I can't rely on my management team to support me. I'm on my own decision making for the turbine. If you look at it this way, he's putting £1 million into the turbine. So what does my powerhouse group, Limited, got to do with it on these lands in New Zealand and Seabed, under the Crown Seabed lease lands? Who pays the bills? Well, I do, really, because I'm resident. He's not. He's a corporate identity director outside of the directorship of the country of domicile. That's why he doesn't want Thailand with this company domicile. That means living there. You see, I'm reading between the lines of the Constitution of Atlantis, Tidal Turbines, because I'm going to protect my idea with the Moai Crown Shield and the King William the Fourth and King William the Third Seal of the British law system of Admiralty, King of the Sea, King's Royal Revenue, prize possessions, that started his country, Thailand, and its Admiralty Commercial Bank law. You see, this started the King's Bench Court in Edinburgh, Scotland. That's why I've got you there, Jackie, and Andy, the Englishman, and the Scot woman, because it's your job to protect Scotland's interest in the native titles in Edinburgh Magistrate Court. Got it? And as for you, Matt Taylor, you're responsible for the safety and security of investment of this Moai Crown standing in Queen Elizabeth Grey Court in London. He's a memorial to the whole world, right there, in my Tahitian royal family, why not? And you've got to protect the King's royal revenue and assets and inheritance, Matt Taylor, because you're in England, where all the laws started from, with these kings in our time. King William III, 1694 Bank of England Act, he put together, and 1694 Pound Note Act, he put together, and the 8-point star on the flag of Admiralty, court martial law, he put that St. Patrick's 8-point star order together. All on this seal. Now, if that's not enough of commercial contracts that these kings started, then King William the Fourth gave us, the native Paramount chiefs of New Zealand, or Ngātua e wā, Aotea, country, before it became New Zealand, by the Dutchman, Abel Tasman, and then the Dutchman, King William the Third, Dutchman. Okay? King Orange. So, they put that commercial flag together. It's the bank, trading bank, private contract of Admiralty contract in Edinburgh Magistrate Court, King George IV, the brother of King William IV, put that together in 1823 with one Paramount chief, Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, from Arapuri in the Waikato district on the banks of the Waikato River, after his name, Waikato, Manukau. You see the picture? That's the native partner to you, eh? Taylor, the living English man. And Jackie, little Gordon, the Scotch partnership with me, the living private contract in these seals. Okay, that's how it works. We're the ones that are supposed to be driving all this commercial world, by the way. Not the thugs and pirates who are running it right now. They have no seals of their own origins and authority, legal. None whatsoever. They borrowed it from here and here. From these two seals, Matt. It's your job to protect what is ours in the commercial world of private contracts that Atlantis is using through Singapore government in a corporate structure that can override, overtake and control any other country's corporate system. Not this one. Not this one. Matt and Jackie, I'll tell you right now. They're in trouble with me and these seals. Because in this country, New Zealand, they have no seal of the Queen of England or Britain. No seal of Westminster. I told the judge that in Auckland District Court. You've got no seal above your head. You've got no Queen above your head. You've got no authority, legal authority over me. No jurisdiction, no constitution over me. I've got it. And my hat that you stole and locked it up in prison. And my uniform with the kings on it. You're in trouble. Well, they wouldn't let me in court. They dismissed it all because they had no jurisdiction over me. The same with this. Good try, but I'm going to be reasonable. I'm going to be diplomatic, and I'm going to be honest. Not cruel, but kind in a commercial world where I'm going to, for the first time, pioneering a new idea, turbine, that makes power look so simple. Jackie, you know the Scots have the brain that's been screwed out by the English and the system of corporations has been largely abused until now. They're going to cash up and put the pound note on their head because you know why? We have a contract that's hard to break. It's extant forevermore, locked in statute law in Westminster Parliament. Now you can see Harry is living in that castle, Adelaide, under Australia in Canberra, where their federal state government is. This is a federal state government, right here. This flag we've got is the only King's Federal State Government flag in the world, Matt. And you know that. You're looking after King Arthur, that's fine. But you know the legal language. Get used to it. We have to follow the system in order to defuse whatever's going wrong with it. Illegally. This is the only way to do it, man. Now is the time to pull in the fraudsters. with these instruments. I'm going to still carry on with Grimm Group Limited in a contract, but under our terms of the King of Britain, UK, England, and Scotland and Ireland, Northern Ireland and New Zealand, Pacific Islands. I'm wrapping the whole lot up from today. I'm going to finish this off. It's going to him, but I won't make it public. Spectacle. No. I'm just showing you and Jackie and Cecile here in confidence of what decisions I make for the whole world watching on YouTube what happens to fraudsters, pirates, under these laws for pirates of these two seals that the Queen is sucking off its authority as if she owned and Trump owned. Now, a message to Trump. Be very careful of what you're doing with the documents I have online. They're real, with a pound note. I sent the pound note, the 970 million trillion trillion pound note, to Harold Lee, Grimm Group Limited, just to show them I do have the money of the King, Royal Revenue, prize possession. Under my hat. That's my equity. That pound note is my equity. So why should I have to borrow money for less under another king? Thailand. No disrespect to the King of Thailand. I'm saying I'm in a commercial world, in control of my own inheritance seals, private contract, PLC. That started all you lot off around the world. Ask, where did you get your authority from? You'll end up on the Queen. So ask the Queen, where did she get her authority from? You'll land up on the King and the Moai Crown, staying in London, in her court, Queen's Bench Court, Judgement Debtors, in our book. The King's Bench Court is silent no more. You got it? So that's all I want to say on this video. The sun's coming out. We'll open the line. Oh, not quite. So, I put this on YouTube because that's my witness. The whole world watching. 1.8 billion Facebook followers of Facebook, not me, of Facebook, and YouTube on this video, for the record, in Britain, UK, Westminster Parliament, and Westminster City. Okay, so I want to go there and put an officer with Matt. Up the road in Westminster, not London, Westminster Magistrate Court, to Edinburgh Magistrate Court, Jackie, Edinburgh Magistrate Court, where all the native titles of the world are there, started off with this Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, Paramount Chief, 1823, and King George IV. They put those titles together. That's my authority. Matt and Jackie, and I'm going to use it on anyone who's breaking those laws. Anyone will get a pound note on their head from this authority. Okay? And the living people, the King's common people, common law, rule. And Moai, L-O-R-E, law, spirit, truth. name of truth, so help me God. That's the Moai law. Soundly. It's speak of. So, at this stage, I will take a week to refine my the new company, Moai Powerhouse Group, NZ, from New Zealand, one, NZ one. Scotland is Moai Powerhouse Group, two. Scotland, two. In Moai Powerhouse Group, Scotland, two. Okay, well, with the abbreviations of Scotland, SC2. Limited. At some stage, I'll make it unlimited. But they wouldn't let me do that here. It has to say limited. Or shares. Ordinary shares. You got preferred shares and ordinary shares. So now this company has 1 billion shares, of which Power Link gets 400 million shares. And I've got 600 million shares ownership of only New Zealand country. Because he's liable with his money. He's £1 million. He's going to turn into £1 billion overnight once the shares get gone. So he method of raising funds for the turbine, which would be about £1 billion. Offhand, £1 billion. He'd have to raise, and I would have to raise. He raised with his share system of preferred shares and my system of ordinary and preferred shares. Split. You see? He would most likely go through the Singapore with the 400 million shares. So, I'll go through Britain with the 600 million shares. You see? That's the constitution of this company, the Moai Powerhouse Group, NZ1. Okay, that's a subsidiary of Ngā Atua Ewa Altair Limited, registered company with 999 shares, well, trillion shares, at £25 a share. Fixed for life. Okay? I can change the company's status later to corporation, unlimited. I'll change it later. I'll diffuse that one like they do and open it up again. I've already done this, my Powerhouse Group Limited in Britain, shut it down and opened it up with my Powerhouse Group Limited company because it wasn't running any revenue. And so now I'm expecting it to run revenue when the £1 million comes out. Guess what, Matt? I'll be opening a bank with the pound now. And then make that go. Forever and ever. With 970 million trillion pounds debt instrument on judgment debtors, including the Queen, the Rothschilds, and all the companies who are screwing the King's royal revenue and authority, his legal authority, and defrauding the people of the world, including Trump. I accuse with the Queen of conspiring to defraud again with new money. What's wrong with the US dollar? Why are they getting rid of it? Like how John Key wanted to get rid of this New Zealand Union Jack flag and put a fern there for a flag. The fern don't belong to him. It belongs to the people in New Zealand. He calls it mums and dads. Big deal. never heard something so thin as thinner money, US dollar. That's going to get the bill of 970 million to return to for its part in conspiring to defraud. Did defraud before they run it out and say, it's no there anymore. It's gone. No, I got you before it went. Committed offence before, during and after the event of Trump signing with the Queen behind closed doors because it's a private company here. We're talking about PLC. Well, guess what? The day of reckoning is close. Matt, your job in Britain is to save Britain. I'll save the world. You save Britain. And Jackie will save our documents in the Edinburgh Magistrate Court. That's where the title jurisdiction is for what I'm doing with our contract right here, made public to the world today on Monday, the 30th of July, 2018. I, Wani Kahaki Wano, or that's corporate name on my birth certificate and passport, New Zealand passport, and John Little Whanoa, the natural name, making this statement today that I am running a corporate business on the open market to sell shares, to raise the money, to build a tidal turbine in New Zealand on the East Coast, on our land block. The Seabed is our land block. I can attest to that in our tribes down there. But their tribes are fraudulent to have changed our king's title to themselves. The Iwi Maori crowd is going to get the bill of 970 million trillion trillion pounds. Everybody who's got the name Maori on their documents, not the people, the documents I'm talking about, that's corporate. I'm in a corporate world with a corporate authority and jurisdiction and a constitution to investigate everybody and their documents that got the word Maori, including the Maori government, falls into that jurisdiction of the Queen's Bench Court. Can't get out of it. Can't get out of it. It's a contract. You're in a contract. The birth certificate is another thing. That's the King's contract. It came from these kings on the sea. And the flag doesn't belong to Maori. You can try it all you like, but it's got no legal authority inside. That's why it won't go anywhere under a Maori system. It can go only under memorials of the Moai standing in London, France, Belgium, New York, Washington DC, Dunedin, with the crown on his head in Dunedin. That's the real crown of the world, in Dunedin. And Auckland. The real Moai statue memorial is my Wānoa Royal Tahitian family. Death. Stick that on the record and see where that goes. See who says it in a High Court of Admiralty in London, because that's where everybody's going to get thrown into it. That argues with that and these seals, memorial titles to everything commercial, banks, contracts, and everything derived through these kings. King William III, his sons, King William IV, King George IV, and King Ernest Augustus, the first, King George III, and King William III. And now King Ernest Augustus the Fourth, the Fifth. King Ernest Augustus the Fifth, a queen, dethroned his title of king, but he's a prince in her world, but a king in ours. She cannot touch the monarch on the king's side with our contract locked privately. None of her business. But this Paramount Chief, 1823. Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, and his descendant, Rewherewhere Manukau. Pukekohe lands. Waiuku. And Pungapunga Marae in Arapuni. They changed the name. They, meaning the Crown of New Zealand and Iwi Maoris, changed the name to Tohara Marae. Poor people. They're not poor people. That's my father-in-law, Mihinu, Peter. And why? Te ora rangi. My mother-in-law and my kids. That's my marae. And the Marangairoa marae. They changed to Awatere marae in Te Araroa, East Cape, where we're building this turbine. That's the original king's title, marae names, that I'm using. And Miles Baker, my friend up here in Hokianga, Tahiki, Mangungu area of Kaikohe District, Northland, New Zealand, and his ancestor up in Tahiti, Horitikuri, and Horitikuri's father, Rāmeka, and Horitikuri's son, Herewhai. Those titles are in the Rāwini Native Magistrate Court, where the British first sailed in 1820s. Okay, link that to Awaroa Native Magistrate Court in Hillsborough. That's where it went with this Waikato title. Tira Waikato Wharehere in the Manukau, and the Manukau family, the Rogan family. The Rogans married the Manukaus, the judges, in their court. And the Rogans married the Wānoas in the other court, down in East Cape, at Rangitukia. Okay? The Magistrate Court in Rangitukia Native Court. That's the Rogans, and the Cosgrove lawyers married the Wānoas. Stick that on the record. It's been hidden from you all. Not anymore. Not anymore. So, those are the titles I'm holding to the whole world of native titles that became instruments to make money in the bank. For all you people unsuspecting of where it all started, this is where it all started to make the money. The king's titles from King Solomon was all consolidated by King William III into the Bank of England. He created that bank and the pound note. The Rothschild came along and bought out the Vatican Bank pound note and the Bank of England illegally, and then screwed the whole King's royal revenue to themselves and the Queen on that bloodline, the King George VI bloodline. We're using King George III, King George IV bloodlines, and King William III and King William IV bloodlines. And King Ernest Augustus, the fifth, the living king. He's 60, thereabouts. And I'm 69, older than him, of status. As the contract holder, he is the monarch successor, but not the bank contract. Not the contract. Matt and Jackie. King Ernest Augustus is the monarch successor to those kings I just said, but not the money, not the commercial bank contract and flag. It was given to these Paramount Chiefs, not to Maoris. There was no Maoris in 1840, even right up to 1945,
when the war broke out here, the First World War, Second World War, Maori Battalion. That was created, it's manufactured, tried, Ngāti Whātua in Auckland here and the Kaipara in Helensville. Ngāti Whātua is not a real tribe. It's Maori, created by the Queen and her corporate pirates to hijack this native title that I'm saying and took the money. Well, get this, it's fraud and corruption at its worst, and it's going to stop with this power note. That's it, that's how it works, man. Anyway, that's all said enough. Better get on with work now, and we'll see you later. Have a nice day. To all of you watching around the world, this is John Wanoa in Kerikeri, Northland, Bay of Islands, New Zealand, making the latest prediction and the latest statement of claim to this Moai statue, memorial, standing in London, and this seal of the kings, I just said King William III, King William IV, King George IV, and King Ernest Augustus I. Titles to jurisdiction and legal authority to run their corporate business here in New Zealand, where it was hidden from pirates. We got them here. We got the pirates here. The same ones in America, owned by the Queen. Not anymore. Trump, you're doing all the work for us. You are a tenant and a subject of the King. Not the Queen, the King. We have our King, live, King Ernest Augustus, no matter what. He has a stake in this 970 million trillion pound note. Debt instrument on judgment debtors that I name. We are the judgment creditors, Matt and Jackie. We are the title holders of the King's inheritance, money, wealth, and prized possessions, King's royal revenue, as Seabed, Crown Seabed leaseholders, Crown land leaseholders. This crown is King, is that entity and that authority, ownership, title holder, with the instruments, legal instruments, and a memorial to go with it. No one can break our contract. Jackie and Matt, both of you are in contract with me, with this King's surrogate. I'm the surrogate of those kings, and I'm the surrogate of these Paramount chiefs here, and I'm the surrogate of Moai Crown, Federal State Government, and the Moai Seal. I have all those documents here with me, and they're online. Everything that I put online is patented under this great seal of the Kings, and the flag that we have, the 1834 Declaration of War on Pirates flag. That's what it is. A state of emergency financial instrument to recover all the debts back to the King's Bench Court and the Moai Crown Native Magistrate Court in Auckland. Okay? And anywhere I wish to set up a court. We use the London court in the meantime, but Westminster is where we're going to use that court. Paddington and the courthouse there and the city of Westminster. Our legal authority comes from Westminster Parliament and these documents. Okay, to Harold Link in Thailand. I'm going ahead with this deal with him and your company, B. Grimm Group, run by your daughter, and yourself as retired. You're in contract with me, because this session. So, I'm locking myself to you in a contract under the King of Britain, UK, as me, the surrogate of that wealth and power notes and legal jurisdiction of Seabed, Crown Seabed, leases and Crown leases from the King's Admiralty Magistrate Court in Westminster, and from the Native Magistrate Court here in Auckland, New Zealand. Okay? So that's me reading to the world watching that this is on the record for the British Westminster Parliament, Westminster City and Westminster Magistrate Court, and to the New Zealand Government in Wellington, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, and the Governor General, Patsy Reedy, and Sean Elias, Chief Justice. Take notice of what I'm saying today, that you have no seal of the Queen, you have no seal of Westminster Parliament, you have no legal authority over what I'm doing commercially in a governance contract situation of debt instruments bank and legal authority that I hold over you and the new project at Ranfurly Bank, Eastgate, under my jurisdiction. I just explained I'm going ahead with the turbine under the Scottish government, laws of the sea, and the Crown Seabed leases. I'm going under those leases because you don't have any experience or jurisdiction of tidal turbines at the bottom of the ocean. You're going to borrow it from someone. But I'm saying I'm going this way, straight to the source of legal authority, past the lawyers here, and past anybody on the bar, because they'll have to match me in court with them standing in front of me with their legal authority over my legal authority. Even though you've got the laws in New Zealand, I'm going under superior law in a superior court. The Chinese go to the Rolls Building Court in London because the courts here don't have any jurisdiction over the money they're spending in the governance structure of corporations that I'm going into right now. I'm pulling to pieces, because I'm a mechanic, to rip it all apart, word for word, to find out who's behind any conflicts of interest against our interests as first party, Britain and the Paramounties of Ngā Atua Ewa Aotea, in other words, the new name of New Zealand and Pacific Islands. Ngā Atua Ewa Aotea, that's the name of our company, Limited. That's exclusive to these British kings' titles and inheritance and legal authority of corporations they created. Okay, the kings created those instruments for me to use on anybody unsuspecting of what I have with native titles in Canada, those people over there, and America waiting, and Australia, and Britain waiting for me, and these native titles that where all the money was derived through the native lands of all the country, Africa, and India, all the East India Company, all those companies have come out of these documents that I'm authorised by my chiefs to use for our tidal turbine project, the Moai tidal turbine, Ranfurly Bank, going ahead. 500 megawatts, I'm making up all the financial plans for that through governance structure of Atlantis model in Scotland, and who's running it, and how they're running it, what for, who for the people or for somebody. You see, I'm for the people. Carol wants the net profit of 40% of everything in the Moai Powerhouse Group. From his group. Group means every name of companies I've got with the name Moai Powerhouse Group on it belongs to me, not to Harold. He's not buying that company. He's buying the turbine at Ranfurly Bay. That's enough money from that, 40% of what it turns out. Maybe 100 million from his 1 million investment. Is that a good deal or not? I say all the people in the world get 100% from what I do. If I had the £1 million in my bank account of my own, I just need to go and get Cook Street, that's 2.75 billion in the bank account. The ANZ Bank is not playing ball with this. They're giving me a hard time. They're not interested in what I do. Well, the land underneath them is shaking at the moment because I've got the title for it. They can't prove where they got it from because they got it from pirates, not from this Waikato chief. That's what I've been saying all along. Why they lost the case is because they don't have title to the land they're standing on, occupying over. They only got occupation leases. Guess who's got the lease? Never thought of that, mate. You ever thought who holds the lease? It's you and I and Jackie. That's who holds the lease, legally. Okay, that's enough. See you later. Bye. Have a nice day.